Stand and join us for our processional hymn.
Thank you. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Peace on earth and good hope to all forever.
Amen.
Strengthen our Lord and our God, our weakness by your mercy, that we may celebrate the holy mysteries which have been given from the renewal of redemption of our weak nature. The mercy of your beloved Son, O Lord of all, forever.
Amen.
I will extol you, my God and King. Hallelujah.
I will extol you, my God and King.
And bless your name forever and ever.
Every day I will bless you.
And praise your name forever and ever.
Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised.
The Lord takes pleasure in those who fear him. Hallelujah.
And in those who hope in his steadfast love. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Let us pray. Peace be with us.
We adore and glorify the green holy name of your glorious Trinity for the grace that you have given us, O Lord of all. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, forever.
You are all the servants of God.
Come, all you people, saved by the cross and received the body and blood of Christ, who suffered for us. Let us plant in our bodies and souls humility, faithfulness, and holiness, so that there may be no faults in our service and be condemned before his judgment seat. Let us pray. Peace be with us.
When the pleasant fragrance of your tender love embraces us, our Lord and our God, we are enlightened by your truth and made worthy to welcome the revelation of your beloved Son from heaven. They will praise you unceasingly and glorify you in your crown church, filled with all graces and blessings. For you are the Lord and Creator of all forever. Savior of our souls and the faithful garden of our lives. It is right to thank, adore, and glorify you at all times, O Lord of all, forever.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Lord, one who dwells and delights in the saints, we implore you, Lord, turn to us, forgive us, and have mercy on us always, O Lord of all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, forever. Amen. Align us, our Lord and our God, that we may listen to and understand your pleasant, life-giving, and divine commands. Grant them through your grace and mercy that we may gain the gifts of love, hope, and salvation for our bodies and souls, and always sing perpetual praise to you, O Lord of all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, forever.
From the book of Exodus, bless me, Father.
May Christ enlighten this teaching and make you a worthy model for those who are listening to you.
The Lord said to Moses, cut two tables of stone like the first, and I will write upon the tables the words that were on the first tablets which you broke. Be ready in the morning, and come up in the morning to Mount Sinai, and present yourself there to me on the top of the mountain. No man shall come up with you, and let no man be seen throughout all the mountain. Let no flocks or herds feed before that mountain. So Moses cut two tables of stone like the first, and he rose early in the morning and went up to Mount Sinai, as the Lord had commanded him, and took in his hands two tables of stone. And the Lord descended in the cloud and stood with him there, and proclaimed the name of the Lord. The Lord passed before him and proclaimed, the Lord, a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in mercy and faithfulness, keeping merciful love for thousands, forgiving iniquity and transgressions and sin, but who will by no means clear the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children and the children's children to the third and the fourth generation. And the Lord said to Moses, write these words in accordance with these words that I have made a covenant with you with Israel. And he was there with the Lord 40 days and 40 nights. He neither ate bread nor drank water. And he wrote upon the tables the words of the covenant, the 10 commandments. When Moses came down from Mount Sinai with the two tables and the covenant in his hand, he came down from the mountain. Moses did not know that the skin of his face shone like he had been talking with God. And when Aaron and all the sons of Israel saw Moses, behold, the skin of his face shone, and they were afraid to come near him. But Moses called to them, and Aaron and all the leaders of the congregation returned to him, and Moses talked with them. And afterwards, all the sons of Israel came near, and he gave them in commandment all that the Lord had spoken with him in Mount Sinai. And when Moses had finished speaking with them, he put up a veil on his face. But whenever Moses went in before the Lord to speak with him, he took the veil off until he came out. And when he came out, he told the sons of Israel what he was commanded. The sons of Israel saw the face of Moses, that the skin of Moses' face shone. And Moses would put the veil upon his face again until he went up to speak with him.
The mighty one God, the Lord, speaks. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The mighty one God, the Lord, speaks and summons the earth from the rising of the sun to its setting. Out of Zion, the perfection of beauty, God shines forth.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Let us pray. Peace be with us.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Blessed God.
May Christ enlighten this teaching make you a worthy model for those who are listening to you.
Now this I affirm and testify in the Lord, that you must no longer walk as the Gentiles walk in the futility of their minds. They are darkened in their understanding, alienated from the life of God because of the ignorance that is in them due to their hardness of heart. They have become callous and have given themselves up to licentiousness, greedy to practice every kind of uncleanness. You did not so learn Christ, assuming that you have heard about him and were taught in him as the truth is in Jesus. Put off the old man that belongs to your former manner of life and is corrupt through deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit of your minds, and put on the new man created after the likeness of God in true righteousness and holiness. Therefore, putting away falsehood, let everyone speak the truth with his neighbor, for we are members of one another. Be angry, but do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger, and give no opportunity to the devil. Let the thief no longer steal, but rather let him labor, doing honest work with his hands, so that he may be able to give those in need. Let no evil talk come out of your mouths, but only such as is good for edifying as it fits the occasion, that it may impart grace to those who hear. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, in whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and slander be put away from you with all malice. And be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another as God in Christ forgave you. Therefore, be imitators of God as beloved children, and walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. But immorality and all impurity or covetousness must not even be named among you as is fitting among saints. Let therefore be no filthiness, nor silly talk, nor levity, which are not fitting, but instead let there be thanksgiving. Look carefully then how you walk, not as unwise men, but as wise, making the most of the time, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. And do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with all your heart, always and for everything, giving thanks in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to God the Father. Be subject to one another out of reverence for Christ. Let us all stand and prepare ourselves for the Holy Gospel.
Come, O sons, listen to me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. What man is there who desires life and covets many days that he may enjoy good? Keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking deceit. Depart from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. Hallelujah.
Shlamam chon. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew.
Glory to Christ our Lord.
And when Jesus was baptized, he went up immediately from the water, and behold, the heavens were opened, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting on him. And lo, a voice from heaven saying, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased." Then Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. And he fasted 40 days and 40 nights. And afterward he was hungry. And the tempter came and said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command these stones to become loaves of bread." But he answered, "It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God." Then the devil took him to the holy city and set him on the pinnacle of the temple and said to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down, for it is written, he will give his angels charge of you, and on their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against a stone." And Jesus said to him, "Again it is written, you shall not tempt the Lord your God." Again the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and the glory of them. And he said to him, "All these I will give you if you will fall down and worship me." Then Jesus said to him, "Be gone, Satan, for it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only shall you serve." Then the devil left him, and behold, angels came and ministered to him. Ushuha lala minai.
Thank you.
good to be here with all of you. They just said my name right over here. I'm Father Kevin, if you don't know me. I served as a deacon here, so most of you probably have seen me running around here once in a while. So it's good to be here with all of you. Don't worry, I'm not replacing Father Patrick. He'll be back soon. He's just taking a little break, but I'm just here for today. Actually, I just got my new assignment. It's going to be at Holy Martyrs. It was 50-50. It was going to be here or Holy Martyrs, but don't worry. I'm going to Holy Martyrs. Inshallah. Inshallah, ta'un amokhun soon, so no worries there if you're worried, okay? Very good. Today's gospel, we have a beautiful gospel before we start Lent, where we have Jesus, he's baptized. And so he's baptized, and the Holy Spirit comes upon him. We have to know that in this moment, the moment of Jesus' baptism, is the moment he decides, I'm going to do it. I'm going to die on the cross. Even though Jesus doesn't have any sins, and he's baptized, we have to think, why is he baptized? He's baptized because in that moment he's saying, I'm one of them. I'm one of the people. I'm going to take their sins upon myself, and I'm going to save them. And so when Jesus decides to do this, immediately the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, takes Jesus into the desert and to fast for 40 days and 40 nights. And so obviously that's why we have Soma. We'll be in the Chaldean church, it's like 50 days, but it's okay, we're more penitential. And so 40 days and 40 nights, but where do we get that from? Why is Jesus doing this? So if you're familiar with the Bible, and you know that Jesus, when he was a baby, he lived in Egypt, right? And now he's in the desert. Why is God doing this? He says, out of Egypt I've called my son. So the same thing with Israel, the Israelite, Jesus represents the people of Israel. And Israel were slaves, the Israelites were slaves where? In Egypt. And then they came out of Egypt and they went into the desert, not for 40 days, but for 40 years. And so that's why Jesus is fasting for 40 days, because the Israelites were in the desert for 40 years. But what happened to them in the desert? For 40 years, the devil was tempting them to sin. But instead of being like Jesus, they fell. They got tempted, they fell into sin, they got tempted, they get back up, then they were tempted and they fell into sin. And so in the desert, they were complaining. They said to God, we don't have any food. And so God gave them bread that fell from heaven. And then they started complaining more. They said, we're sick of this bread that you're giving us. Give us meat. And then he gives them quails, birds to eat. He gives them flesh. He gives them meat. But then they kept sinning in the desert. They started committing immoral sins, impure sins, sexual sins in the desert right in front of him. And they kept falling. And God still was showing them mercy. And so what happens in today? The devil now, Jesus represents the people. Where the people failed, we fail, we have sin. But Jesus is going into the desert where he's going to succeed for the people. The devil's going to tempt him. Turn these loaves, turn these stones into bread. So what does the devil ask from Jesus? He's saying to him, take a shortcut. Here are 40 days are already almost over. They're over. You're hungry. Turn these stones into bread. Show me that you are really the Son of God. And so sometimes the devil does that to us. He says, take a shortcut. Cheat. You're hungry? Steal. You don't have enough material possessions? Do whatever it takes. And that's what Jesus is being tempted. He tempts Jesus. He says to him, I'll give you all the kingdoms of the world and all the wealth and all the power of them if you worship me. Well, the funny thing is, Jesus is already the king. They already belong to him. And he's tempting him, saying, I'll give them to you right now if you worship me. And this is what the devil does. He says, the devil tempts us. He says, if you do these immoral things, I'll give you wealth. I'll give you everything. And it's an illusion. And so today, I want us to really just go through that. For example, how does the devil tempt us? Well, one thing could be lust, right? Food represents more than just the physical body, has needs, has desires. It's not necessarily a bad thing. When people want a beautiful relationship with their wife in the right order, but out of the wrong order, the devil tempts us. He says, don't wait till marriage. Take a shortcut. Be impure. Take a shortcut. You want the pleasure of marriage now? Take a shortcut. Don't wait. Cheat. Or when you're married, the devil can put in your mind, he says, this marriage isn't what I thought it was going to be. I'm not happy anymore. The devil puts in your mind, you're not happy? Take happiness for yourself. Cheat. Just like Jesus is doing to Jesus. Take the luchma for yourself. Cheat. Don't wait. Don't fast these 40 days. He says, take a shortcut. The one main one I want to talk about today really is a few different things about, well, the main one I wanted to give us an example of the way the devil tempts us is drugs, with drugs today. And the example I want to give is I'm going to use an analogy, and just bear with me, to help us understand what the devil's doing today. So imagine, a lot of you probably have a store, a party store, maybe you have you worked in a beer and wine store or something. Imagine if a young little boy, you know, some of you are little here, young, 10, 12 years old, came into your liquor store, and he said, give me a pint of Johnny Walker Black. Okay, let's say he says that, give me a pint. You would be looking at him like, you're crazy. I'm not selling you any alcohol, right? We wouldn't do that. Most people here, if you had a 10-year-old come into your store, a 12-year-old, and he would say to you, give me a pint of liquor, you'd be like, we're not doing that, right? Would you do that? No, probably not, shaking your head. Okay, no. No, we would not do that. Okay, so what if he did do it? What if the store owner was like, you're 10 years old, you're old enough, here you go, have some liquor. What kind of sin is that? So I want to explain a little bit to us, how do we know something is a mortal sin? So this example, I'm giving you an example. How do we know this is a mortal sin? It's grave, it's serious, and you know that it's serious, and then you freely choose to do it anyways, and you know it's serious. That's a mortal sin. So if a little kid came to you and he said, give me a pint of liquor, and you gave it to him, you're like, yeah, I know it's serious, maybe he's gonna get hurt, but go ahead and do it. That's a mortal sin. Today, we would never do that in the store, right? But we are doing something else, the same exact thing. And what we're doing today is the devil has been tempting our community, everyone that I know pretty much, tempting the community to sell marijuana, especially on the streets. You know, whenever someone comes to me, people come to me all the time and they want to talk to me about marijuana, and I say to them, how are you selling it? And every single time a person has literally come up to me and they say, on the black market, illegally on the streets. Illegally on the streets. And I looked into it, and the people don't really realize a huge percentage of that marijuana goes to who? Between the ages of 10 and 17, get those drugs. They do get them. Little middle school kids come up to me and say, and to Father John and me at St. George, they say to us, everyone is giving us weed. They're literally middle school. They say, everyone's giving it to us, Father. What should we do? They're just giving it to me. And so we think that they're not getting it. Oh, but they are getting it. And then we have to learn from the scripture. How serious is this to Jesus? He says in the Gospels, he says, if you even cause not 100 kids to sin, not 1,000. He says, if you even cause one to stumble, if you even cause one of the children to sin, just one. The example Jesus gives is so severe, he says severely, and don't worry, Jesus can have mercy on us if we repent, but he says severely, he says, it's better for you to have a stone tied around your neck than for you to cause one of these little ones to even stumble, just stumble into sin, and for you to be cast into the sea with that stone. And so, is it grave? Yes, it is. It's grave. If I know that it's grave, and then I freely choose to do it anyways, like I said, it's not just one mortal sin. We are living in that mortal sin, right? And so why is it so important to talk about this? Because if we don't talk about it, one day we're going to be caught off guard, right? You know, one day we're all going to stand before God when we die. And then you might be caught off guard. Unexpectedly, he's going to show you every single person that sinned through your hands. You know, Jesus says in the scriptures, he says, temptations to sin are going to come. He goes, there's going to be lots of people who are going to be tempting people to sin. But he says, woe to you if it comes through your hands. Woe to you, you a Christian who have been baptized, who received the Eucharist. He says, if the sin comes through your hands, he says, be careful. He says, I know the little ones, the children, they're going to be tempted. But he says, if it comes through your hands, watch out. This is what's going to happen. So one day for all of us, and even all priests, if we don't speak the truth, he's going to say to you, me, Father Kevin, I'm going to show you the face of every single child that committed these mortal sins and got high. It's your fault because you didn't say anything. And then that stone's going to be for me 100 times worse than anyone in this church, 1,000 million times worse. And so while we have a chance, Jesus can save us from that, right? If we're in this church, Jesus is trying to say, I want to save you. He wants to save me. And so he's going to show us the face of all these little kids that committed every single mortal sin. He's going to say, this is what happened through your hands. Why? Because Jesus loves kids. He loves these little kids here. Do you know how much they mean to him? He has such a passion. He literally warns the disciples. He looks at the 12 apostles and says, if you even dare to hurt these kids and make them sin, Jesus has a fire. He has a passion and is very serious. So this is something that we should, if we're confused about it, we need to talk about it because we're a family. And if you've been tempted to do this, you know, God loves you, you know. A lot of times people don't understand the severity of it. They think it's just like alcohol. But if we sold alcohol in the same way I gave you that example, if we sold alcohol in the way that we are selling marijuana, it is a mortal sin. It would be a mortal sin to sell alcohol in that way. And so it's the same thing. It's a mortal sin to sell weed, especially in that way. And so, but that's the way the majority, far majority of people are doing it. Just ask, how are you doing it? They just tell me, on the black market. So I sit down and I say, well, let's have a conversation about this. Because you are in danger. If I don't tell you, don't think God is just gonna keep you off the hook. You're gonna be caught off guard on the day of judgment. You're gonna be like, oh crap. That day when you're before him, and you're gonna be like, uh-oh. And then we can't repent on that day. The time of repentance is now. That's what Lent is about. It's not about giving up candy and chips and all that. Sure, we can do that, but what's the point of that if we're living in sin? If we're living in sin, my Lent means nothing. And so the first thing we need to do our best to ask ourselves, where is he tempting me? What parts of my life am I just giving over to him? And I'm not giving Jesus my full heart. So today let's pray that we have such a good God. Jesus is in the desert and he's saying, I'm going to defeat Satan for you. I'm going to go on that cross and I'm going to win heaven for us. So today, when the devil is tempting us, let's truly let Jesus save us and let him be our savior today. Amen.
Let us stand well with joy and gladness, and let us implore and say, Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
We pray for the church and all the leaders within her. They lead by an example of holiness and joy. We implore you.
Lord, have mercy on us.
For those that have left God because of a tragedy, may they see that God has plans much higher than we can comprehend, and trust that he supplies all that we need to triumph over evil. We implore you.
Lord, have mercy on us.
For a decrease in gossiping in our everyday lives, for as St. Paul says, let no evil talk come out of your mouths. We implore you.
Lord, have mercy on us.
For a fruitful and productive Lent for all the members of St. Joseph and in all churches, that we strive to be Catholics, that God calls us to be through an intentional increase of fasting, prayer, and almsgiving. We implore you.
Lord, have mercy on us.
For all those that we know that have died, may their souls be raised up in heaven through the mercy and love of God. We implore you.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Together, let us entrust our souls to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit forever.
O Lord Almighty God, we beseech and implore you, fulfill your grace in us and pour out your gifts through us. May your divine mercies and love be the remission of debts and the forgiveness of sins of all your faithful, whom you have chosen for yourself in your grace and mercies. O Lord of all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit forever.
Oh,
command, our Lord and our God, by your command, our Lord and our God, by your command, our Lord and our God, these glorious, holy, life-giving, and divine mysteries are placed set upon the absolving altar for the second coming of our Lord from heaven. To him be glory at all times and forever. حلاوه ولورا ولروح قدشا المذبح قدشا نهوية أخرانا دو ثلتا مريهم يمدالها كل عمامين وامين دخل المر يوسف المذبح قدشا أم كانت انسا حسد الدذكال We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son
give you thanks, O Lord, for the abundance of your grace, though we are sinners and wretched. But through your mercy, you have made us worthy to serve the sacred mystery of the body and blood of your Christ. We ask help from you for the strength of our souls, so that with perfect charity and true faith we celebrate your gift to us, and we raise to you glory, honor, thanksgiving, and praise, now at all times and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us, now at all times and forever.
Amen.
Lift up your thoughts.
To you, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, the King of glory.
This sacrifice is offered to God, the Lord of all.
It is right and just.
The name of the glory. glorious Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, is worthy of glory from every mouth, thanksgiving from every tongue, and adoration and exaltation from all creation. O Lord, you created the world in your compassion, and redeemed mankind in your mercy, with countless heavenly beings who worship your greatness, myriads of angels, beings of light and spirit, who glorify your name. And with the holy cherubim and spiritual seraphim offer adoration to your majesty, they proclaim by saying... your worth and offspring of your bosom, the likeness and the glory of your splendor, and the image of your substance, he did not deem equality with you as something to be robbed, but emptied himself and took the form of a slave. He left us a memorial of our salvation, this mystery which we offer before you. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread with his sacred hands, raised his eyes to God, his almighty Father, gave you thanks and blessed. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you for the forgiveness of sins."
Amen.
In a similar way, after the supper, he took the cup with his sacred hands and gave you thanks and blessed. He gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. The mystery of faith will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins."
Amen.
This is my blood. Whenever you do this, do it in memory of me.
We believe and confess.
As you have commanded us to be your humble, weak, and feeble servants, you have gathered here to celebrate your great mercy toward us, which cannot be repaid. For you, our Lord and our God, have assumed our humanity that we may live in your divinity, exalted our lowliness, raised us from our fall, revived our mortality, forgiven our debts, justified our sinfulness, lined our minds, and overcome our enemies. For your help and grace is toward us, we lift to you glory, honor, thanksgiving, and praise, now, at all times, and forever. Lord God Almighty, accept this sacrifice which we offer you. For all your blessings bestowed on Our Lady, the Blessed Mary, ever virgin, and all the just and pious fathers and pleasing to you, all the prophets, apostles, martyrs, and confessors. We offer also for the Holy Catholic Church, for our holy fathers, Mar Francis, the Supreme Pontiff, the Pope of Rome, Mar Louis the Patriarch, Mar Francis, the Bishop of our diocese, Mar Ibrahim, our spiritual father, for all bishops, priests, deacons, monks, and nuns. Accept the sacrifice, O Lord God Almighty, for all who are in sorrow and distress, the needy and weary, the sick and afflicted, for all the deceased who departed from our midst of this people who gaze and await for your mercy. May this sacrifice be accepted, our Lord and our God, for all who are present before your holy altar. Hear their prayers, pardon their sins, and forgive their iniquities. Also for this country's inhabitants, the city, and those who dwell in it, protect the Lord by your grace, and dispel all evil from it.
O Christ, the peace of those in heaven and on earth, fill the world with your peace and harmony. O Lord, especially in your holy Catholic Church, bring harmony between church and state, put an end to wars on earth, and calm the nations that desire war,
and we also, Lord, are your humble and weak servants who are gathered in your name and stand before you at this moment. We have received through tradition the example of your Son. While rejoicing, glorifying, and exalting, we commemorate and celebrate this great holy life-giving and divine mystery of the passion, death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Silence and in reverence, stand and pray that
May your Holy Spirit come, O Lord, and rest upon this sacrifice to bless and sanctify it. May it become for us the pardon of debts, the forgiveness of sins, the great hope for the resurrection of the dead, and new life in the kingdom of heaven with all who have pleased you. For this great and marvelous providence for us, we praise and glorify you without ceasing in your church, redeemed by the precious blood of your Christ. With praise on our lips and radiant face, we raise glory, thanksgiving, and praise to your living, holy, and life-giving name, now at all times and forever.
Amen.
Cleanse the odor of our iniquity, our Lord and our God, with the sweet aroma of your pleasant love. Wash every stain of sin, O good shepherd, who searched for us, found us lost, and delights in our return. Forgive our debts and sins, those that we know, as well as those which are unaware, in your grace and mercy.
Amen.
The grace of your mercy, our Lord and our God, is near to these glorious, holy, life-giving, and divine mysteries, although we are unworthy. With true faith in your name, O Lord, we approach these holy mysteries. In your mercy we break, and in your compassion we sign the life-giving body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, forever.
Amen.
The precious blood is signed with the life-giving body of our Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, forever.
Amen.
The sacred body is signed with the forgiving blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, forever.
Amen.
Set apart, sanctified, perfected, united, and sealed one to the other, these glorious, holy, life-giving, and divine mysteries, and revere and felt the name of your glorious Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, may the mysteries, Lord, be for the forgiveness of our offenses, the pardon of our faults, the great hope of the resurrection from the dead, and new life in the kingdom of heaven for us and for the Holy Church of Christ, our Lord, which is here and everywhere, now, at all times, and forever.
Amen.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us, now at all times and forever.
Let us approach with piety and reverence the mystery of the precious body and blood of our Savior. With a pure heart and true faith, let us recall his passion and meditate on his resurrection. For our sake, the only begotten of God took from humanity a mortal body with a rational and immortal soul. By his life-giving laws and his holy commandments, he led us from error to the knowledge of the truth. According to his plan of salvation for us, the firstborn of our humanity was tested on the cross. He rose from the dead and ascended into heaven. He gave us his holy mysteries, by which we recall all his graces for us. Therefore, with overflowing love and a humble will, let us receive the gift of eternal life. Let us participate in the mysteries of the church through pure prayer and deep contrition. With hope in our repentance, let us convert from our iniquities, weep over our sins, and ask mercy and pardon from God, the Lord of all, as we forgive our neighbors their offenses.
Lord, forgive our sins and offenses.
Let us purify our conscience from division and dispute.
Lord, forgive our sins.
Let us purify our souls from hatred and hostility.
Lord, forgive our sins and offenses.
Let us receive this communion and be sanctified by the Holy Spirit.
Lord, forgive our sins and offenses.
United in one mind, let us receive in harmony these mysteries.
Lord, forgive
Let these mysteries, Lord, be for the resurrection of our bodies and the salvation of our souls. Let us pray. Peace be with us.
Forgive, O Lord, your mercy, our sins and offenses, and sanctify us by your grace. Make us worthy, our Lord and our God, to stand always before you with pure hearts and radiant faces, with the filial confidence from your mercy. We call upon you and say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Yes, Lord God Almighty, you are good and Father full of mercy. We beg the greatness of your compassion. Do not let us fall into temptation, Lord, but deliver us from the evil one and his hosts. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the authority in heaven and on earth. Now at all times and forever.
Amen.
Shalom Amchon.
Amen.
Kodshal Qadisha Yab Shal Musa.
Let us worship the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit as we sing Hallelujah.
Sanctify our bodies by your holy body. Pardon our sins by your precious blood. And purify our conscience by your mercy. Christ, you are the hope of our nature forever. Amen. May the gift of our Lord Jesus Christ be perfected in all of us through his mercy.
Forever and ever. Amen.
Come, let us adorn ourselves spiritually with spiritual fasting that cleanses iniquities. Let us worship the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit as we sing Hallelujah.
Let us
shared in the reception of these glorious, holy, life-giving, and divine mysteries, let us thank and glorify God who has given them.
And for his indescribable gifts.
Let us pray, peace be with us.
God was with every spiritual grace in heaven through Jesus Christ our Lord. God was with every spiritual grace in heaven through Jesus Christ our Lord. Has also given us his body and blood as a pledge of life that cannot be corrupted. May he bless our assembly.
Amen.
Protect our community.
Amen.
Purify our people.
Amen.
We have come to be renewed by the power of the glorious, holy, life-giving, and divine mysteries. By the living sign, Lord's cross, we be sealed and preserved from all evil, both hidden and manifest, now at all times and forever.
Amen.
With just one quick announcement. On Tuesday, we're having the Saints talk that's going to be starting to happen. Saints group on Tuesdays. It's going to start. Father Patrick wanted me to tell you. And there's a poll that he also wanted you to tell you. Is that outside?
No.
The poll? Yeah, go ahead.
If you go to our Instagram page, there are highlights, they're called highlights. You click on them, there's polls. You just pick what saint you'd most like to learn about. That way, you know, whichever one gets the best votes or the most votes, that's the one Father Patrick will talk about. So it's going to start Tuesday 25th at 7 p.m., which means Tuesday Mass will be moving to 6:30 p.m. So it will be Tuesday 6:30 p.m. Mass, followed by the Lives of the Saints program.
Thank you, and have a happy Sunday. God bless you.
Thank you.